Hello, ladies and gents. Welcome to Face the TV here for some more Red Dot Invitational. Now, winner goes to LAN is what this match is, what these teams are playing for in this match. Vexed and EnVyUS, of course, you would definitely favor EnVyUS, but their performances recently have certainly been a little bit, they've been kind of slumping. And so soon after their great results, after winning the major, James, is the honeymoon period over?
I don't know what to say in response to your question, Dan.
That's fantastic.
What I'm going to say is they're still one of the best teams in the world. Let's not go crazy.
Okay, I would like some more insight.
Vexed also, you know, they were in the they've been playing recently for Counter Strike.
All right, this is going well.
Look, man, I'm just here for the lunch
fish?
Food.
We're going to say fish.
I'm just here for the fish. No, Envy. You know, sometimes you're going to win, sometimes you're going to lose versus the top teams. They lost to Luminosity, but they went all the way to the final. Yep. And they took the first map in the final as well. So read into that what you will. I wouldn't hold that against them. I would expect them to come out with a W in this best of three, as I'm sure everyone else would.
Mm. We are a little bit delayed because Happy was, well, his location was unknown. His teammates couldn't figure out where he was. He was somewhere in the Nether Zone. Now, we'll have to see whether or not EnVyUS can get off to a good start. They have a history of being one of the best Inferno teams that are out there. And, you know, with their individual skill, even if they're not, you know, on point strategically or with the coordination, any single player can explode. And we're just about to see a bit of an explosion here from Vex, the Polish side, looking to move straight in. And Happy, what is this? This is very awkward, but Happy's managing to pick up a couple of frags at the very least before finally going down. So he kind of did his job here. But Apex is about to pass someone through the smoke as well. This is also quite awkward. That smoke has been quite devilish so far.
He's passed Rallen again, but this time he's going to get wrecked, and the reckoning is going to come back the way of Rallen. kioShiMa to finish things off here. So the CT side is a successful one. The CT start, sorry, is a successful one. Happy in the usual spot. I guess they were waiting for the buy round to start looking for Happy in such a place, but of course, Happy is always behind the smoke.
Indeed, it's a bit of a crazy round, and either way, all said and done, EnVyUS will be on a better economy than Vexed, but Vexed have opted with the bomb plant to actually force it up, more or less. Although, interesting. They did get the bomb down, didn't they?
I don't think they did, actually, no.
Okay, yeah, that would make sense, because their buy doesn't actually look like they
no.
would. I mean, if they would have gotten the bomb down, they'd have much more to force with here. That would have been cool to see. Anyway, the force buy is coming out regardless, which is the standard play from the T side, and they're looking to get the pressure in towards the banana area, but there are, of course, lots of smokes, flashes at the disposal of the CT side, and when it comes to the defense, we've got NBK with big pop-up pump, and the MP7 on Happy, so it's good defensive setup.
Well, I don't know how many kills NBK can realistically get from this position. So it's a slow gun for a rush. There we go. Happy's going to get the only frag, and that's going to be via a Molotov. So good start for Vex. They should get the bomb plant down as well.
Yeah, we've got Kenny S already making his way from CT. He's going to be the first man in. The run and gun is going to provide a nice result there. Two frags for Kenny S, opening things up for his team. Carving a path, and this nade is going to be money. There it is. Lovely stuff there indeed. So we'll have EnVyUS now winning the second round as well, effectively defending against that force buy, although the bomb did get planted and they did lose three players. So Vex can absolutely justify the investment that they threw into that round there with the force buy. And in fact, as a response to the damage that they did, the pressure that they put on EnVyUS's economy, and getting the bomb down, having that extra cash from that, they've opted to go for another force buy here. And you can see how much that extra $800 per player, thanks to the bomb plant, is really going to add to the round, as Vex have three rifles, although only one is an AK, but the Glil should be pretty effective as well. That's one of the major differences, apart from the general damage per second that you can get out of the AK-47 between the Glil, is that the AK-47 is a one-shot kill when it's connecting to the head, whereas the Glil will require two shots if the player has a head armor, the helmet, as it's otherwise known. All right, so we'll have the Vex side looking to go for the push into the B bomb sites. And EnVyUS have a bit of a setup going on here, but Happy's actually on a 5-7. This is not ideal. They might not be expecting such a play from Vexed. You have actually hidden their weapons thus far, and Happy's only going to go down after one frag. So this is not a good look for the French side as they look to make their way back into the bombsite on the retake. They are a man down, but Kenny S will sort that out. He'll even things up on the numbers as Vex look to get themselves a solid defensive setup. And they don't have much breathing room. This pressure is immediate in from the EnVyUS side here as they're trying to make their way in. They're close to breaching this. Kenny S is in such a key position. He can't win the fight against GruBy though. That's a really important one. Great stuff there from GruBy. Getting the second one, that should surely be the last nail in the coffin in this round for EnVyUS, as indeed Apex is going to be finished off and Vex will win the round. So a very fast way back into this one after EnVyUS did win that pistol round. So great play from Vex there, and they are definitely a team that can certainly fly under the radar when it comes to people's perspectives on how the top tier actually looks. They can certainly beat anybody, and their best of three, their map pool is pretty decent as well. It's not going to be as deep as a team like TSM or Virtus Pro, but still, Vex are pretty solid across the board. And of course, they also have some LAN results, and a 2-2 also back that one up as well. So EnVyUS will decide to force it up themselves in this situation. We've got the two rifles and just pistols, full Kevlars, lacking a couple of helmets, only one kit. So it's a little bit stretched, and they will stack everybody towards the B-bomb site, kind of gambling together to try to mitigate the disadvantage by using superior numbers. And in fact, they're going to actually push down Banana as well. This has not yet been spotted by Vexed. This could be quite a surprise because they're going back towards Banana. Could they be caught moving out of position here? We have an all-out brawl between both sides. It's just one player left in Furlan for the Vexed side. And he's going to have to clutch this one now, but Kenny S is going to come in with that triple kill to finish him off, and that's going to be the round there for EnVyUS. Very, very unlucky that Vex decided to actually double back in that position. But equally, to try to make that round work for yourself, realistically, being up against EnVyUS, they do have the proclivity to force buy in more or less every single situation. So you do want to have a player to kind of fact find, so you can at the very least, you know, you can have an expendable player that can get you the information. Have they stacked somewhere? Because that is what really was the one way that Vex could lose that round, and that is indeed exactly what happened. Just making the blind play back into the B sites did not work out for them. So we'll have Kenny S aiding his teammates over towards the B area, giving them an extra smoke. And that is going to certainly delay any efforts that Vex have, unless they want to force the issue through the smoke. But that's always going to be unfavorable. And teams generally will probably be quite wary about doing this against EnVyUS because of their history of Happy. But there you go. Happy's actually a bit further back, but still the frags are raining in here for the French side. Beautiful setup. Well executed. Never looked like they had any problems at all there. Very quick indeed. Very quick and clean. So 4-1 as EnVyUS will break Vexed on their their round loss bonus. So at least Vexed had everything. Oh, sorry, enough money to throw in one more buy. But if they lose this one, it's going to be a pretty harsh eco for them. And this would be a very important round for them to win, considering the fact that that EnVyUS is starting to get a lot of momentum here. So we'll have apartments taken over quite quickly here from Vex, and it's not something that they've put a lot of effort in before. And they're actually charging a bunch of players out of balcony. Very unexpected play. Not so often you'll see that, but it's going to completely catch off EnVyUS, and they will have a bomb plant now, but it's a 3-on-3 with the B players rotating in for EnVyUS, looking for that retake, and it's going really well so far. We've got NBK and Kenny S picking up kills, leaving just Pete left alive in the pit position as he looks for the first oncoming players. There you go. It's not going to be able to stand the test of even the first one, failing all the trials. And at the very least, they did get the bomb down, but three players surviving there for EnVyUS is certainly going to be very nice for them. Now we have Vexed with that bomb down. They can actually get a few pistols in there. We'll see some nades from Hyper as well. It's always good to have some nades on a round like this. I mean, the flashbangs can help you to break some choke points, and the smoke as well can provide cover if you're actually, you know, in a potential where you can get a bomb down, or, you know, you've got a really severe choke point to watch out for, which has big ranges to try to block off. It can be very effective in those spots. So the smoke's already used here by Vex. Not sure exactly where the smoke actually went. It's likely that it was there towards quad, freeing them up towards arch side. In fact, it was. And there you go. They're going to be using their flashes as well to get around to a library side. But look at this range that kioShiMa has to play with. And now they're being funneled through the arch side into two players. And somehow they'll actually make both frags. That was very unfavorable, but Vex will make it work. Picking up the AWP onto Furlan as well. He's quite a beast with that thing. So they need to be very careful. And he's going to find the frag onto Apex. Too smart for Apex in that situation. And now we've got the 2-on-2 with 50 seconds on the clock, so quite a hard situation for EnVyUS to work out what's going on. They don't want to push too much. They want to stay in good positions. The more you're moving, the weaker you are going to be if a fight is going to break out. You can see Happy is hesitant to move. Perhaps not aware that already a player has crossed. He'll smoke off his flank as well just to keep himself safe and to deter any T's that could be on Banana, but in fact they are both towards this B bomb site, towards construction and CT. Here comes Furlan, and wow, what a shot there. I am very surprised they even expected that angle. That's beautiful stuff. And that's going to be the bomb down, and kioShiMa now looking for the retake. This is absolutely a doable situation considering that there is no Kevlar on either of these two remaining players from Vexed, which is a rather large deal as he's going to be able to get more damage on the shots, but also the aim punch is devastating. Once you get tagged with no Kevlar, you can barely hit a single shot. You lose all your accuracy. So kioShiMa just trying to bait someone out, but realizes that this potential crossfire is going to be too severe to deal with. And he will keep his M4 Kevlar and Diffuse kit alive. So Vex making that one work, that's pretty damn impressive. And it was all because of the ability to breach the arch side, which kind of was by design for EnVyUS. We saw that there was two players from EnVyUS who were trying to kill the players funneling through the arch, and they just couldn't get the frags in time. And Furlan picking up the AWP, that was the major difference. Then picking up two incredibly important frags afterwards with that AWP with great prediction. And Vex are straight back in it. EnVyUS do, however, have some money to get the buy going, though, so they will indeed do that. And they don't even have a poor buy at all. It's looking very strong indeed. They've got all the smokes and incendiaries, which can be used effectively to delay their opponent and force them into a harder decision later in the round, as is essentially the story of an Inferno match. And Vex, they desperately need to string some rounds together. They can't be winning one and then losing one. That's horribly detrimental for them at this point. So this is a must-win really for Vexed if they want to have a decent T side. We do have Happy just going for the re-smoke. We have seen EnVyUS smoking that off with Kenny is helping from arch side, throwing it all the way over so they can have 3 or 4 smokes onto that choke point. Quite wary of the push from Vexed. Vexed a very aggressive side. Happy lies in wait. Not behind the smoke directly, which is what he's known for. He has to play against the expectation. Everyone is so wary of exactly how Happy likes to play these positions. He's going to flash himself in, expecting the push. There's the first frag. He's doing a perfect job right now. There's 3 players down, allowing NBK to get a very easy follow-up onto GruBy. This is completely terrible. It's a catastrophe right now for Vex. They don't get almost any damage in there. Just only 1 player and no bomb plant. A very well-handled round by EnVyUS, leaving Vexed in this situation where they're going to force it up. And if they didn't just get the bomb down so consistently, they would be really screwed. And I mean, it's really starting to get that momentum going, but there is yet more work to be done here for both sides. Especially EnVyUS, their economy is actually not too great at the moment. The CT buys are incredibly expensive. Oh, great opener there. Rallen looking for the aggressive play, and he's going to catch Apex almost immediately. And there's one player down for the CT. So the CTs have a choice now. Either they play 2 to a site and play very passively, or they try to get aggressive somewhere. On Inferno, it's harder, much harder to do that effectively. And the setups you can have as 2 players on either site can be quite strong. So usually we'll see that. And that's what's happening right now as we see EnVyUS waiting to see what's going on at the moment. Vex realized that the arch side is going to be very vulnerable in this kind of a situation because EnVyUS have to remove a player from somewhere. And usually it's going to be the player on arch that's going to be leaving that area open.
Well, you can see Happy's re-smoked Banana, so he may be committed to A for a little while. Still a man advantage here, and he's allowed him to fall into the trap. How many can he get? There were many heads looking in his direction, but they're all going to go towards the B bomb site now. You can see NBK trying to slow down with the Molotov. He's going to do a good job because they are tagged by Happy, so that's going to cause problems. 5, 17, 20 HP for these last three Vex players. Bomb plant looks unlikely despite it being a 1 versus 3. Though they've got a smoke grenade that could make all the difference here. Nade coming in as well, and NBK is going to wait patiently for his teammates.
Yeah, this looks really good actually for EnVyUS due to the health, as you mentioned. Happy did a great job. They're getting the tags in. And it should be easy to finish off. This incendiary is going to be amazing right now. He knows at least there's no one by the new boxes. And he will spot the player by second oranges. So looking quite fantastic here for EnVyUS. And they will clean up with three players still left alive. So a very strong situation once again created by EnVyUS, despite losing a guy immediately. And you have to wonder there, you know, Vex, they really should have been able to accomplish more in that round after the immediate pick of Apex.
So we're going to have Kenny AWPing now as Envy have all their players back. Vex is going to be on a bit of an eco here. We've got those P250s coming out. Furlan going for the Deagle. So we'll see if Vex can get any damage done in this round. They've got two flashbangs, so perhaps they can use that to get top of Banana. Or they can throw a pop flash top mid and then go for a fast push if they can get a kill. Could potentially try and go for a split, as they did in the previous round. Although, they're starting to lose the numbers here. Had a 1v1 duel on Blana, which was won by Happy. But they have got that arch player down, but then that's it, pretty much. Peet alone versus 4, just with a P250. Bomb, at this point, isn't really relevant, so we'll see. He's not going to bother to go back for it, because he knows that it's extremely unlikely that he's going to get a bomb plant here.
Yeah, EnVyUS starting to have a really solid CT side. They could even get well into the double digits at this point. I would expect them to get up to 10, but whether they can get past that, of course, that's really up to how Vex play this one out now. And EnVyUS have definitely been hitting their shots, as opposed to a match we had recently where I expected a lot of situations to work out for TSM, but then they just weren't quite connecting. But EnVyUS here today are connecting as you would expect them to do so. And we'll have the AWP on Rallen again. Oh, he's going to hit the shot onto Kenny S as well. Great challenge there. That will work out for Vex. But last time they got the early man advantage, they couldn't capitalize. Will this round be different?
EnVy opting for an abandonment of the arch area for the time being. But Happy is headed over there. Again, Happy is carrying a smoke as well. Though the current smoke is at the bottom of Banana, and Ryland's just going for the pot shots there, but not finding the connection just yet. NBK finally goes down, and Vexed aren't going to capitalize on that, actually. That's obviously going to pull Happy straight back towards the B bomb site, so Envy's not going to gamble their team on one site alone. 5 versus 3 now, and that's definitely going to be a stretched CT side.
I really like what EnVyUS actually tried to do there, though. They got three players onto the A site, and had the one guy deep on Banana. Of course, you put a lot of responsibility on that guy, but with the level of skill you have on the team of EnVyUS, that's the kind of play that you can make, realistically. But here you go. Happy's going to get challenged by the entire team. This could be very dangerous indeed. He knows what's going on. He's going to make the call to his teammates, and he's actually got a perfect situation for the spray. He gets two players, but that's going to be it, it would seem, as he has to rely on his teammates now coming in for the retake, but he did at least get two frags there. So 2 versus 3 is a doable spot here for EnVyUS. On the retake, kioShiMa and Apex certainly not favored, but it's not too bad. And here they go.
Yeah, a lot of damage has been done already on these two remaining players. Now that nade could be it for Furlan, and indeed it will be. The 3-pointer there. Ruby's left behind the spools. And Apex will be facing him with a knife out, waiting for his teammate, and he will go for the trade.
James.
He's styling. He's styling
what
and profiling, Dan.
It looked like he just basically, like, he jumped up. He saw the guy, and he like span around in his chair, and like, then he did like the 360, and then just like landed back, you know, in position, got the mouse out, and shot the guy.
Well, whatever he did, it worked, and it's going to give Envy a 7-round lead with NBK going for the auto sniper. Ooh. The land special, Dan.
Yeah, we saw this. This essentially that auto sniper buy for NBK onto the B side of Inferno was what basically broke what seemed to be a never-ending overtime against G2. It was the difference maker. And there was no answer for that. And NBK is donning the auto sniper again. It's always good to see NBK with these kinds of weapons. But Kenny S, look at that. Look at this. This is fantastic.
Look at this.
Beautiful stuff from Kenny S. He's looking for the ace at this point. Pulls out the pistol. He'll run into his death. But it's okay. He's done more than enough damage. And it just seems like EnVyUS are just too strong at the moment. Their individual skill is overpowering Vexed. They can't quite win these battles. Everything is just happening for EnVyUS.
Yeah, very nice play by KS at the beginning. They're positioning himself to avoid the flashbang in the first place. And then The terrorists were just on the edge of the smoke there, getting punished by the man who could see all. Legitimately, of course. Kenyas on the AWP and NBK on the auto. We've got the double arch set up, so we're going to have support for the AWPer over there. While we have a player up close in Happy. Letting the players run past, looking for the spray gun. He's got one, he's a bit blind. They know he's there, but they're blind as well. He's going to get taken down in a trade. NBK is in position.
He's rubbing his hands, James.
Oh, that's horrible for Pete because he essentially accidentally got baited by a teammate. He jumped on the cart, moved away, and Pete tried to jump sideways, I think, and got shot in the head.
Yeah, that was really nice. NBK, he's just sitting there, just, you know, shining his auto sniper, rubbing his hands. He's salivating, James. Oh, that's actually a pretty cool nade. Didn't go quite far enough, yeah. But if you can get that maybe a little bit further, that'd be fantastic. That's a really nice one. But it looks like we will get another frag into middle here from Furlan. The problem for Vexed is that there is no health on these two players, and Rallen doesn't even have any Kevlar. So Rallen's in a position where he's going to get completely destroyed by more or less anybody unless he connects the first bullet. And his teammate Furlan is also in a similar spot. And here we go. We'll get the creep from Rallen. He's going to be looking for this, but NBK is on the angle. And there it is. Great reactions. As expected from a player of his caliber. And now Furlan has crept onto the A-bomb site. So the distraction actually allowed him to plant the bomb, even though he's going to die to this nade.
Smell you later.
It's that worked out. That was actually the best case scenario.
Yeah, they got the plant. That's so a Brucey bonus.
So I respect that.
But there are only two rounds left in the half, and they only have two rounds in the half. So they will be looking for more. And NBK will be looking for the BGs, the bad games there, not the GGs, the BGs.
He wants to stall on people, he wants to rub their faces in his auto-sniper superiority. Now you've got Rallen on the AWP again, he's been doing well with this. KennyS, however, on the AWP as well. And we'll have a passive opener from Vexed as they just try to see if there's going to be any aggression from EnVyUS, which there has been in quite a few of the rounds, so you can't blame them for... Well, essentially doing something that's for free, which is looking for aggression, using the time to their advantage. And we see now they are deep on banana, starting to get deeper into apartments. Now that all that's really left to do is to do an entry take into middle, or go for an execute on B. Those are kind of your two main options at this point. And once middle's taken, then you can think about doubling back to B or committing to A.
Ooh, look at these deep angles that both the Envy players are holding. Apex looking to get some trades though, but he's going to be forced back to the site. And there is a player, I believe, in graveyard there, which is kioShiMa, I would imagine. Well, now it's a double short play. But, Envy's going to get, sorry, Apex going to get wrecked straight away, and Kiyoshima's going to go down as well. So, that is an opened up A bomb site. We'll see how much money Envy have. They probably have, well, actually, Happy's only got $1,200, so between NBK and Apex, they can probably buy for the rest of the team, so I think they're going to be going for as much damage as possible.
Yeah, absolutely. It should be quite doable to get some damage in. I think they realistically expect that they cannot really win this round from this point with so many players left alive. But they can surely make this one burn on the way down. Although Vexed are doing the smart thing and essentially not going really into the areas in which they don't have knowledge of. And they will spot the setup from EnVyUS. So EnVyUS picking up a frag there at the end, but it was really just a great series of entry frags, one-on-ones that were won by Vexed in the middle area, that allowed them to just go for the A play basically. So that's not happened consistently for them. When they've tried to do stuff like that previously, EnVyUS have been smacking them down. So it's not really a play with which they can go to with any level of consistency. So have to see if they, you know, if they'll try to do the same thing this round or. That said, actually, though, James, nothing really has been working for them. Even the, you know, the execute hasn't been working for them. It's 11-3 after all.
Indeed it is. So, last chance saloon here in the first half for Vexed. Pistol will, of course, be extremely important after an arduous half. Just the last round. Three in banana at present. This time, a different approach. Ooh, Rallen, is that a boost kill?
Yep.
I think it was, indeed. So, NBK getting caught short there on banana. That's going to cause a bit of a rotation, actually.
The problem, though, is that Vexed have to be careful here because the bomb is still by T-spot. So they need to hold their horses before they really go too deep into the B-bomb site and lose too many players. KennyS is now repositioned as well, so that can very well be the reality as the pick opportunities coming in from Rallen, but boom, KennyS is going to deal with that, expertly so. And now the move for the bomb has occurred for Vexed, and they're going to remaneuver into the A bomb site. Looks like that will be the final play to end this first half from Vex, but will it be successful? We have already EnVyUS encroaching upon their position. Great shot again coming in from KennyS.
Yep, so Vex being picked off one by one, and we're not seeing fast responses from them. Finally, Tussie's come out of the balcony, but again, Apex in that strong position on the balcony. Bit of a blind spot as you come in looking towards the site. That's going to leave it Furlan in a 3 versus 1 with 10 HP. He's got to plant the bomb as well because there are only 12 seconds left. Ooh. But Kenny will not allow that, so it will be 12-3 here for Envy on the first map of this best of three.
Yeah, and this looked like it could even have been worse for Vex, actually, in a lot of spots. They didn't really find too many opportunities. They played quite a lot of the rounds in a smart way, in the, you know, the usual strategies that you would expect of an Inferno match. But EnVyUS seemed to have this overpowering level of individual skill and tactical efficiency on their setups defensively. So, I mean, that really shows, as you mentioned previously, just quite, you know, why these EnVyUS is considered one of the best in the world, like a top three level team.
So we've got that initial flash onto Banana, which might suggest a fast play from the T's here. But you can see that smoke has come in front of the car. And Envy will, I was going to say, be forced to wait, but they're going to force their way in, as Envy do. The bomb has been spotted, which means a full rotation here. But we do have Happy behind the fly, but Flowerbot trying to hold off any rotation through Banana. The site still being contested. Going to be taken by Envy now.
Yeah, you can see that Hyper and GruBy had this spot where they're both like, we're both in the same spot because they're running scared because the push seems so close, they couldn't position correctly. And that was completely punished by EnVyUS, and that could give them this round-winning advantage as we see them take over the site, defend very well. Not much really done there by Vexed after that initial double entry. So 13-3, Vexed are going to be likely kicked out of this first map very quickly unless they have something very special to say for themselves. But we have the MAC-10, we've got a couple MP7s, and a UMP, and we have some carnage checks.
Can we see the scoreboard quickly? Okay, so Ryland's left himself $1,000 in the bank, which is curious. That's a quite the gamble here. Presumably for a sniper later on, but yep. I mean, are they going to make it that far? We'll have to see. That is quite a gamble, but at this point, 13-3, can't criticize him for taking such gambles. We'll see if it pays off. That said, there is an undetected Happy in CT spawn, and it seems the CTs have literally no idea.
How did this happen, James?
So we need to go and look at Happy right now before he gets these two kills. Oh dear, what is going on here? He's allowed one to rotate as well. This is, what is this?
Oh my god.
That's ridiculous.
Is he going to get the kill? Kill?
Oh. That's the most ridiculous stuff I've seen from Happy recently. Ooh, a bit of a dink, and this is winnable actually for Vex now. 2 versus 3, but Apex only has 1 HP. Moving into the site to plant here, the CTs are miles away, so the gamble hasn't paid off. Rollins dead, GruBy and Hyper remain.
This is quite the interesting spot, but the problem is with GruBy and Hyper is there's so many spots to check, and they themselves don't have head armor, or helmets, as they're often known, James. Head armor is the technical term.
It's the Dan term, Dan.
So the Dan term. So, looks like GruBy's gonna just...
He's looking for...
Back away. See if he can scavenge.
A charitable donation, Dan.
He should take a chicken with him.
I was actually playing aimbots yesterday, and I clicked the long range, and there were 5 chickens standing behind the wall, Dan. Mm. That's the end of my story, Dan.
I will inform Peter immediately. So we have 14-3 now. EnVyUS looking pretty fantastic. Lots of nades. And what's cool about this round is we'll see the Tech 9 from NBK. So NBK is the ultimate, like, expendable player. He can just run anywhere with that Tech 9 to kind of open things up, draw a lot of fire through a very, what would typically be a nasty choke point, and then his teammates can get through once he's maybe even potentially got a kill, because it is NBK as well. And you might see that towards this B area. Although, where is NBK right now? Yep, he's...
Oh, what was that? He's been flying sideways. GruBy got double naded down to 8 HP and still managed to kill 2 players with the UMP. That is just when you are S out of luck, Dan.
Yeah, I don't know what just happened there. But Hyper's still alive at the back of the site. He's going to get a Molotov out of position and promptly finished off. It looks like Vex are still going to lose the round despite the shenanigans. The ump shenanigans. And Fallon's actually picked up an AK, but it is short-lived. 15-3 now. One more round for EnVyUS to take this one over the line. And oh dear, this match is to go to LAN essentially. So Vex certainly need to try to step things up on the second map, which would be train. But yeah, with EnVyUS in the form that they're currently showing, it's going to be difficult, to say the least.
Ooh, Vex going for the big nades down mid, and they've got a few of them flying down. They're happy they will survive with 2 HP and get a headshot onto Pete. Looking for a second one, he's a man never to fear. He's just going to sit in the crawl space in mid on his own with 2 HP and try and wreck any CTs while his teammates try to get hold of Banana. So his Molly's coming in. GruBy is playing close, though. So he's not going to have the success that Happy usually has. That flash is going to just ruin the party for him, and the B-bomb site's going to be opened up.
And Happy is watching the flank, and in comes Vexed with a hope and a dream. But, well, they are getting quite low at this point. There's not much to say for them, as KennyS is holding down the construction doorway into the bomb site. He's doing a pretty damn good job. That's one frag. That's a second one as well. Just Rallen is left alive. And that is going to be that. 16-3, a very dominant performance coming out of EnVyUS as they show Vexed who is the boss of Inferno.
Well, not much to say about that one. Vexed were never in the gate.
Absolutely, yeah. Again, there wasn't really any rounds where this was kind of working. It's just, there was one round where... Actually, hang on. There was a few rounds where they got the pick immediately, but they still couldn't convert. They still were in this situation where they actually knew what to do. They were moving in the map in the right places, but EnVyUS just outskilled them, more or less.
I wonder what people think of the round where I think it was a 3v5, and Happy smoked them on Banana, and they chose to push through the smoke. And Happy, in my opinion, because Happy tried to... he killed two players, and then he tried to judge where they were by sound and kill them through the smoke. But if he hadn't done that and just waited for them to continue pushing, he probably would have killed all of them in that situation, or as many as his magazine would
because
have
he got,
allowed.
He got two, right?
Yeah. And almost got three. He did like half the damage there. But there was about there were about 30 seconds on the clock there. I don't know what the correct decision is, but I mean, you saw when EnVyUS pushes smoke, there's always a flash behind it, where they just chose to just run through the smoke, and it was a disaster.
Yeah, and I think Happy even got his own pop flash in there as well, so they're just completely screwed. Yeah, that was pretty brutal, but train will be the next map. Perhaps Vex can show something of a different kind on the second map. I do hope so for them. Either way, we'll take a very short break whilst they set that one up, and we'll be right back.